Enough already about the negative news. It's time for uplifting news.
You know, I saw him. I saw the headlights of the train. Didn't think he was going to make it, so I just grabbed him and pulled him out. I just looked, and it's like he's not going to make it. So, you know, I got to do something. There wasn't a lot of time to think. I mean, in my mind, it all went down in slow motion. But I just grabbed him and pulled him out. And my honest opinion, he wasn't going to make it, and I couldn't watch it happen. You know, I don't know what to say, you know. I'd like to think that anybody else standing there would have done the same thing. God put me there for a reason, right? I guess. He got to go home. Hopefully he cures cancer or something. He seemed to be a young man. Got a lot of life ahead of him. And hopefully it's a good one.
We do want to thank you for choosing ABC 15 News at 10. I'm Danielle Lerner.
And I'm Justin Pizzera. Now to tonight's big story, a close call between a train and a Valley woman's car. The terrifying moments caught on video. So watch the top right corner of your screen. A blue car rear-ended by a red truck pushed onto the train tracks as the crossing arms come down.
Well, with just seconds to spare, a stranger actually pulls that driver out. You see that train barreling through. All new at 10, ABC 15's John Treweiler. He spoke with that Good Samaritan.
These are the tracks right here where that crash happened earlier this afternoon. And tonight, a driver is alive and well, thanks to some Good Samaritans who jumped into action. Take a look at a train cruising down the tracks with a car in its sights. You can see people running to help. Gloria Garcia is one of those.
The train was getting closer and closer, and I'm here looking at the train, looking at her. It's like, oh my gosh, she's gonna get hit.
Garcia grabbing the lady inside the car by her arm, yanking her out, and describing the moments when just seconds after a Union Pacific freight train collides with that car.
We both started running, you know, backwards because the hit was getting so close. And then when the hit went, shoo, her car almost hit us from trying to get away from that.
You can see the damage the train produced, that car ending up on the tracks, as seen here when a red pickup hits the gray car from behind, pushing the vehicle onto the railroad crossing. Tonight, Garcia doesn't consider herself a hero, but is just glad she was able to be where she was when she was.
I'm just glad that lady's okay. And she keeps telling me, you saved my life. And I really don't feel I did, but she says I did, and I just thank God I was at the right place at the right time.
Really remarkable there, and it actually gets better. Gloria actually gave that elderly lady a ride home since her car was damaged, saying she's made a new friend today. In Mesa, I'm John Treweiler, ABC 15, Arizona.
John Cena is donating $500,000 to first responders battling California wildfires and another $500,000 to foundations helping firefighters. The WWE star turned actor made the announcement on Twitter on Monday. Now the National First Responders Day as well. In the upcoming movie, Playing with Fire, Cena plays a firefighter. He says the movie showcases first responders, people he calls heroes. He also discussed the massive fires burning in the Golden State, saying, quote, our first responders are working around the clock and they need our help. Katie Johnston, KPIX 5 News.
A lot of people are talking about today. It's a breakfast favorite for us.
Well, it might be starting your day with kind of a cheap meal. Uh-huh. I don't know if you guys know this. We've been talking about it. It's National Donut Day.
Yes, finally. It's the way to sugar rush your day. One popular spot, Krispy Kreme, of course. And while there are a bunch of locations across town, well, they aren't everywhere.
No.
So this is 21-year-old Jason Gonzalez. He's a college student, very enterprising. He lives in Champlain, Minnesota. It's a tiny town about 30 minutes north of Minneapolis. And, well, there isn't a Krispy Kreme there, so he decided to fill the void. He would drive 270 miles to a store in Clive, Iowa, pack his car with upwards of 100 boxes of the sugary delights, drive back 270 miles the other way, and then sell them to people around his town for $17 to $20 a box. Now, he said some of his customers spent nearly $100 every time he came back with donuts. He recently heard from Krispy Kreme, who initially told him to stop hustling their goods.
But this is the interesting part. They've actually had a change of heart since this story went viral. And yesterday, Gonzalez heard back from Krispy Kreme. They say They're going to give him 500 boxes and let him work as an independent operator so he can keep doing what he's doing. Gonzalez says he's using this to pay off his student loans. So,
okay.
Turned out all right.
Yeah. So we've got this up on our 8 News Now Facebook page, and here are some of your reactions. Rich wrote, "Is it any different than Uber Eats, Grubhub, etc.? Don't we pay for somebody to pick up food for us and deliver it to us?" He found a market and ran with it.
Indeed he did. David said, well, he paid for the donuts. They're his to do with as he likes. Fair enough. Rocco commented, "Keep your hustle. College won't pay for itself. And besides, Uber Eats and Postmates do the same thing."
There we go. And Stormy said, "Black market donuts are delicious." Aren't they always?
Yeah.
You can join the conversation on our 8 News Now Facebook page. Yeah, I mean, he is an entrepreneur.
Because not only are the normal goodness of the Krispy Kreme donut, but there's like a little edginess to it, too, because
exactly.
you're kind of breaking the law,
yeah.
but you're not. So it's like a little more tasty.
Mm-hmm. And just think about it, you know, those are well-traveled donuts.
Yes.
I mean, he went out of his way to bring donuts to, you know, his townspeople.
Mm-hmm. Bringing joy and happiness.
That's right.
And despite making extra money, he's also helping the economy of Clive, Iowa.
There
Absolutely.
You go. That's true. Nobody else buys that many donuts.
Yeah. I don't think so.
No, they don't.
Probably buying them out.
Like a 10% markup. That's what you got to do to pay off your college loans.
Yeah. So.
This is just one of the key plays that Sherman High School senior Gage Smith made at their game against West Mesquite on Friday. But it's what Smith did after the game that most people remember.
When you're playing the game, you're playing to win, and the other team is the enemy. But afterwards, you know, you still have the respect for the other opponent.
Smith says he knows West Mesquite player Ty Jordan from a select 7-on-7 team they both played on. Jordan's mom is battling cancer, and Smith asked to pray with him after the game.
Just had a moment with him, praying over him, his mom, and his family.
Smith says in that moment, it wasn't about the score or being opponents. It was about showing compassion. Jordan's aunt posted the pictures to Facebook, expressing how much the gesture meant to their family. So far, it has over 100,000 shares.
To see that it blew up, I was very surprised by it, and I wasn't expecting it to be like that. You know, it was just doing it for him and doing it for his mom and his family.
Sherman football coach J.D. Martinez says Smith has been a team leader on and off the field.
He's a true leader, and he has compassion. And I think it follows through for a lot of our guys on our team.
Martinez says his wife happened to capture the special moment, and she sent the pictures to Smith's mom, who passed them on to Jordan's family.
Pretty special that kind of everybody gets to see really what he is. He's that type of kid all the time. It's just not in front of the cameras or anything like that. He's like that every day.
Football brings people together in so many different ways, and that was just one example of it that night.